Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain you horn antenna. Before I start with explanation, let me show you how many things that I'm going to cover in this video. See, first of all, I'll be discussing about basics of horn antenna. After that, I'll explain you structure of horn antenna. After that, I'll explain you flaring length calculation of horn antenna. After that, I'll explain you different types of horn antenna. After that, I'll explain you designing parameters of horn antenna. And at last, I'll be discussing about applications of horn antenna. So let us begin this video with first agenda, that is basics of horn antenna. Structure of horn antenna is based on flaring of the waveguide. Let me explain you how. See, here we have horn antenna with which input is given by waveguide. If you observe the dimensions of waveguide, so that is quite small. By giving flaring to the waveguide, we can enlarge the dimension by horn antenna. So here we have waveguide that is having smaller dimensions. After providing flaring, we are enlarging the dimensions, that is horn antenna, right? See, horn antenna that is having directional radiation characteristics. If you observe the radiation characteristics of this horn antenna, then major lobe that will be there in the direction of axis of horn. If I say this is what axis of horn, then major lobe that is getting formed in this direction, right? It is having directional radiation characteristics, right? See, horn antenna is having better impedance matching with free space. See, here we are delivered to radiate power in free space. So, but obviously, to have directional radiation characteristics, there has to have impedance matching. So, horn antenna is having better impedance matching with free space. If you talk about waveguide, then waveguide is having impedance that is around 50 plus or minus 10 ohm. While if you talk about free space impedance, then that is eta, that is 120 pi. In terms of value, it is 377 ohm. So waveguide is having mismatch of impedance with free space, you can observe. But by providing flaring, we can increase impedance of horn antenna, by which we can have proper impedance matching with free space, that is resulting into directional radiation characteristics. And because of directional radiation characteristics, horn antennas are used for long distance communication. Now, I'll explain you structure of horn antenna. Horn antenna structure is based on flaring of the waveguide. If you observe, here we have waveguide that is having dimensions as per vertical dimension is small a, horizontal dimension is small b. By providing flaring over here, we are increasing the dimensions. With waveguide, dimension is small a with vertical dimension. With horn antenna, it is increased to capital A. And with horizontal dimension, we have small b dimension with waveguide. With horn antenna, after flaring, it is increased to capital B. Here one should know, see, with this horn, we are providing flaring with vertical dimension as well as horizontal dimension. So this is pyramidal horn antenna, that one can say. And vertical dimensions, that is associated with electric field plane, and horizontal dimensions, that is associated with magnetic field plane. Right. With pyramidal horn, we will be having flaring with horizontal as well as vertical dimensions. If you talk about waveguide, then waveguide is having approximated impedance, that is around 50 plus or minus 10 ohm. And if you talk about free space impedance, that is 377 ohm. So there is a large mismatch in between waveguide and free space impedance. That's why waveguide cannot be used as an antenna. But by having a flaring with horn antenna, we are increasing impedance. And if you can increase impedance up to free space impedance, then there will be proper impedance matching. That is resulting into higher directivity. The reason is If you have proper impedance matching, then directivity will increase. One more thing that you can observe, see with horn antenna, we have larger dimensions. Because of larger dimensions, we have larger physical aperture over here. So from large area, we can receive EM waves, right? And because of larger dimensions, we have larger directivity as well. So by flaring, there are two things which is happening. One is physical aperture is increasing, that is resulting into larger directivity. Second is, by having flaring over here, we are increasing impedance of waveguide. With dimensions which are smaller dimensions, we have impedance around 50 plus or minus 10 ohm. That is quite mismatch with free space impedance. And by having flaring, we will be increasing impedance. By increasing impedance up to free space impedance, we can have proper impedance matching. Right. Now here there are few important terminologies that you need to understand. As I have told you, see, vertical dimension, that is associated with electric field plane, and horizontal dimension, that is associated with magnetic field plane. Here I'll be taking cross section with respect to vertical dimension. See, if you observe this cross section, then here we have waveguide in which vertical dimension, that is having magnitude of small a. After flaring, we have increased dimension, that is capital A, that you can observe over here. If you observe, see, we are providing flaring up to length L. So this L is flaring length. If you take arc of this flaring length, then here it is coming like this. So if you observe, here we have delta E difference, right, with respect to this diagonal. So this delta E, that is E plane flaring difference. Why it is E plane flaring difference? The reason is, see, this vertical dimension, that is associated with electric field plane. Here, see this theta E, that is flaring angle with E plane. Similarly, if you observe here, horizontal dimensions are with respect to magnetic field plane, where with waveguide we have small b dimension, and with horn antenna we have capital B dimension, where one can have delta H and theta H as per the explanation which I have given with respect to E plane, right? So that is how basic structure is possible. Here I have explained you structure of horn in which we have flaring with horizontal dimensions and vertical dimensions. That's why this is a structure of pyramidal horn. Now I'll be explaining you how one can identify flaring length of horn antenna. To identify length of the flaring, I'll be considering vertical dimensions with respect to E plane. In E plane, if you observe, here we have horn antenna structure where with waveguide dimension is small a and with horn antenna dimension is capital A. Here, see, length of the flaring, that is L over here, and theta E, that is flaring angle with respect to E plane. If you consider this triangle, then with this triangle, see, this much distance is length L, this much distance, that is L plus delta E, and for triangle, this much distance, that will be A by 2. So based on this triangle, we can apply Pythagoras theorem to this triangle. If you apply Pythagoras theorem over here, then diagonal square, that is L plus delta E square, that is equals to one side square, that is L square, plus second side square, that is A square by 2 square, means A square by 4. If you further elaborate this, then L square plus 2L delta E plus delta E square is equals to L square plus A square by 4. Here, if you observe, see this L square and this L square is getting cancelled, and see delta E square is there. If delta E's value is small, then square of small value, that is even further small. So you can neglect this. If you neglect this, then you will be having length of the flaring, that is as per 2L delta E is equals to A square by 4. So L is equals to A square by 8 delta E. So this is what length of the flaring with respect to E plane, right? That is how one can identify length of the flaring. Here there are few essential things that you need to note down. See, here there can be question like, what can be the limit of flaring? The reason is, if you increase the flaring, then but obviously dimensions of horn that will increase. But up to what limit one can provide flaring over here? So that is based on delta E and delta H value. So there is a threshold of limit on delta E and delta H. See, delta E limit, that is up to 0.25 lambda. You cannot exceed the value of delta E beyond 0.25 lambda. And delta H limit, that is up to 0.4 lambda. If you increase delta E and delta H beyond this value, then horn antenna will stop to radiate. Now I'll explain you types of horn antenna. Types of horn antenna is based on how we provide flaring to the horn antenna. If you observe, here we have pyramidal horn antenna, in which if you observe the waveguide, then with waveguide we have flaring with vertical dimensions as well as horizontal dimensions, right? Vertical dimension, that is associated with electric field, and horizontal dimension, that is associated with magnetic field. So if you have flaring with vertical and horizontal dimensions, you can say we have pyramidal horn. If you observe sectoral E-plane horn, then in that we are having flaring with vertical dimensions only, and vertical dimension, that is associated with electric field. So you can say this is sectoral E-plane horn. In sectoral H-plane horn, we have flaring with horizontal dimensions only. Vertical dimensions remain constant over here. So horizontal dimensions are associated with magnetic field. So this is a case of sectoral H-plane horn. And if you talk about last category, then here we have cylindrical waveguide that is having flaring over here. So that is conical horn antenna. That is how different types are there. Now I'll explain you designing parameters of horn antenna. Based on directive radiation mechanism of horn, one can identify the designing parameter of horn. Like, as if you talk about this horn antenna, then it will be having directive radiation characteristics that will be having major lobe like this, right? And with this major lobe, see, here we have axis of horn. Here we have axis of horn. Now with this axis of horn, we are dealing with to identify horizontal dimensions and vertical dimensions. To identify that, with this major lobe, we need to see how we need to have half power beam width and first null beam width. Half power beam width with vertical dimension is associated with E plane. That will be 56 degree divided by A lambda, where A lambda is A divided by lambda. Half power beam width with horizontal dimension, that is associated with magnetic field plane. That will be 67 degree divided by B lambda, where B lambda is B divided by lambda. If you want first null beam width with E plane, then it will be 115 degree divided by A lambda, and first null beam width with H plane, that will be 170 degree divided by B lambda. So based on requirement of directive radiation pattern, one can select dimensions of A and B. Once you select the dimensions of A and B, you will have to identify length of the flaring. See, length of the flaring, that one can calculate by A square divided by 8 delta E for E plane, and similarly one can have for H plane, that will be A square divided by 8 delta H. And one should know delta E and delta H, that cannot be greater than these limits, otherwise horn cannot radiate, right? So that is how one can design dimensions of this horn, right? Here one more parameter that one should know, based on this equation, there can be so many questions in competitive examination as well. Gain of horn antenna, that is 4 pi AE by lambda square into efficiency, right? So 4 pi AE by lambda square, that is directivity of horn antenna, right? Now at last I'll be discussing about applications. See, usually with feeding of reflector antenna, we use horn antenna, right? So usually you'll be observing In feeding of reflector antenna, we use horn antenna. For short range radar also, we can use horn antenna, as well as in microwave engineering, there are many applications. Here I have not listed many applications of horn. You can search out different applications with horn antenna. Right, here I have just listed few applications only. But still, if anything that you like to share, just note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.